I'm here with Steve Mason.
Hello.
Who's playing tonight in the Miles Davis Hall before Tori Amos, which is a kind of a weird combination.
It's a very strange combination. A lot of people have remarked on that.
Are you a Tori Amos fan?
No.
Not at all. You've never met her either.
No, I've never met her. No. We move in different circles.
So you're not going to change your set at all to please Tori?
No, I'm going to change it to compete with her directly, head to head.
Now, on your MySpace, it says that Steve Mason is all that. Quote, he's all that. Mm. A quote from Noam Chomsky.
Yeah.
Is that actually true?
Yeah. No, it's a little known fact about Noam Chomsky, but Noam Chomsky is quite street. He's quite a street kind of guy.
Now, your new album is under the name Steve Mason, which is a new thing for you because you've also been known as King Biscuit Time and also Black Fair. And so now.
And the Beta Band.
And the Beta Band, of course, but that was with other guys. I mean, you've done solo projects, but not under your own name.
Yeah.
And so you just feel super confident now that you're like, fine, I'm just Steve Mason.
I think it was a combination of two things, running out of pseudonyms, running out of ideas for names for pseudonyms, and my manager kind of bullied me into using my own name. The thing about me is I've always wanted to make so many different types of music. And when you make the more extreme, it's kind of weird to have them all coming out under the same name. It just didn't seem to fit. So I don't know. I mean, already I'm having ideas about the next album and I'm thinking, well, I'm going to have to think of a pseudonym for that. But I can't do any more pseudonyms. I'm going to have to keep it under this Steve Mason from now on. So I don't know what's going to happen with that. I think if I had another pseudonym, it would just be ridiculous.
there'd be too many search results to things
to search
on Google.
During the Black Affair thing, there was a time when I had five or six different MySpaces, all with different genres of music, all with about five or six like fans, like, you know, the Friends thing, about five or six fans.
And you were saying before that there were so many different things you wanted to try in music, and it's interesting that you chose someone like Richard X to produce this album. Your new album, for those who haven't heard it yet, is pretty acoustic, more stripped back. There's electronic elements, but it's kind of a weird choice on the surface because Richard X is known for producing pop hits for Khalees or Sugar Babes, that kind of thing. Yeah. Why did you choose him to produce your album?
Even in the Beta Band, I always wanted to work with a proper pop producer. But unfortunately, that never happened with the Beta Band. You just said that, you know, I chose Richard X, but it really wasn't quite like that. He kind of chose me, really, because when I was doing Black Affair, he sort of approached me to do some stuff with that project. But then while we were sort of talking about it, I kind of slowly shelved Black Affair and started doing this thing. And I wasn't sure he'd really be into this, but we sort of talked about it, and I demoed a lot of tracks. And I mean, my idea with this album, which he was really up for, was kind of, if you stripped away the pianos, the acoustic guitar and the vocals, you're left with a kind of set of R&B style backing tracks, you know, and if you did the opposite, you're left with a kind of singer-songwriter style album. So, you know, he was really into that idea. I mean, Richard X hates rock music, I'm not a massive fan of rock music. I like some stuff, mainly older stuff, but he loves pop music. I mean, he really obviously loves pop music. So I just really like the idea of working with someone who was quite militant about keeping that in mind the whole time while you were working, because I think that sometimes I'm apt to go off in directions and let little things last too long. You know, something that you can say in 20 seconds, I decide to say over 4 minutes. So it's I just thought it'd be really interesting. It's worked much even better than I thought it would. It's really, really worked well, you know, and I think he's done a great job, and you know, and the songs really were strong enough to sort of stand up to the iron rod of X.
Have a great concert tonight.
Thank you very
much. I'll be there as seeing you kind of give it to Tori.
Yeah.